Hi everyone, assalamualaikum. My name is Abir Abdul Rahim. I'm a full-time pricing actuary at an insurance company. For me personally, having been in the workforce for like 8 to 9 years now since I graduated, I learned that effective time management is not about having to do a lot of things in a day and not just about staying back at the office more than the expected office hours. But if you are going to stay back at the office, you have to make sure that you are able to deliver whatever that is on your plate. That means that you are as productive as the number of hours that you put in at work. If let's say 5 days a week you are investing a lot of your time and resources at work, but you have to make sure that during the weekends you have some time for yourself, meaning that you have time to reflect, to meditate, or just to spend time with your family members. So for me, effective time management is how productive you are at work and also how productive you are in terms of managing your relationships with your family and friends. I just use a simple Google Calendar. I think that is something all of us should start utilizing the moment we start working in our life. Google Calendar, every time you set an appointment with your family and friends, you put that in your Google Calendar. Every time you have meetings at work, you put that in your Google Calendar. And make sure that you're able to integrate as well your work calendar with your personal calendar so that your appointments don't clash. That is one thing that I have practiced since day one. But at the same time, I feel that the way I manage my time, I set expectations with my family especially. For example, if I am able to spend time with them one weekend in a month, then I will let them know which weekend that I will go down and visit them in Malacca, for example. Because I think as we spend time at work and climbing the career ladder, we also forgot the fact that our parents are also growing older, right? And this is very important that you have to set expectations, not just with your friends, but also your family members. That's number one. And number two, I learned how to prioritize myself at work at the same time. So if you are an ambitious person and if you are a go-getter, you tend to want to do more at work, right? But sometimes it is very important to be able to say no. And it is very important to also assess and strategize your resources, whether you are able to meet the expected deadline or whether you are able to meet the expectations of your employers as well. My tips will be, number one, I will ask them when do they need this task to be delivered, because it's very important to know what their deadlines are. And number two, as I explained earlier, I would assess whether I have enough information and knowledge and resources to work on that particular task. And number three, I will also manage the expectations in a way that you never commit 100%. If you start committing at the very beginning that you can deliver at a certain deadline, that is, I would say, a mistake that a lot of people do at the workplace. Because, for example, your boss comes to you and say that, I want to see financial results by Monday, right? And then that means you have to work during the weekend. But then do not straight away say, yes, I will deliver by Monday. Just say, yes, you will try your best to deliver by Monday, because you need time for yourself. You need time for your family members. For those parents, you need time to spend with your children. That is how I manage distractions as well. If the thing is very important that I need to prioritize, I would look at the things on my list, for example, and then I would start prioritizing what is the first item that I can deliver. But at the same time, I would try my best. If things start to pile up, right, I would also try my best to clear the clutter, for example, to address the low-hanging fruits, so that your pile on your plate becomes much lesser and you're able to breathe better and you're able to focus on the bigger chunk on your plate. So that's how I manage my distractions at work. I don't believe in work-life balance, but I do believe that you can integrate all these priorities in your life. So I call it work-life integration. I think some of us have come across this term. What it means is that, okay, for example, if you want time for yourself by during the weekend, but then at the same time, you need to catch up with your friends, right? So ask them to join you during your me time. If you want to go for a manicure, ask your friend to go and join you so that you guys can catch up. That is one. Number two is you have to make sure that you enjoy your work. And if let's say you want to have a discussion with your boss, right? I feel that employers should try to practice this work-life integration call the staff out, you know, for an activity and then do that discussion together. Just like how the men are playing golf and secure deals at the golf course. We can do that as well over coffee or over bowling or ever some fun activities. That is work-life integration. And I think to young graduates, if you don't understand what it means, it is basically an approach that creates more synergies between all areas that define life. That means from work, home, family, community, personal well-being and health. So you can't have it all. You can't expect work-life balance in the start of your career. Of course, you have to impress your employers, but you're smart and you have all of the resources and information at the click of your finger. Sort your life out by seeking for meaning and not just impressing and proving your life to people.